God for this privilege and this opportunity this morning for him using me in this sacred position. I want to thank God for our pastor, Davis, and our lovely presiding Sister Rogers, who I don't think ever made a mistake. Praise God. I want to turn your attention this morning. Had a little blunder there when it was in 2 Chronicles.
Would you like to read the
record? No, I'm going to have to write this one. It was in 2 Chronicles. We're going to turn our attention to the word. This morning we're going to be in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verses 12 through 16. And I want to thank God for this privilege and this opportunity for being here with Mount Zion. As you know, that Mount Zion is a very loving church. It has a reputation of standing by and being there for you. I'm a recipient of that love, and I am who I'm in today because of the way Mount Zion loves. And I just want to thank God and give Mount Zion their proper kudos because they have been a loving church. I want to thank God for you. And as we turn our attention this morning, we've already read, you read, was hearing, but I'm going to take over right now by the move of the Spirit. And the Lord appeared to Solomon by night and said unto him, I have heard thy prayer and have chosen this place to myself for a house of sacrifice. If I shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Now mine eyes shall be opened, and my ears attend unto the prayer that is made in this place. For now have I chosen and sacrificed this house, that my name may be there forever, and mine eyes and my heart shall be there perpetually. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his holy and divine word. And I come to you this morning with a subject. God's divine confirmation. Let us pray. Father God, in Jesus' precious name, I come as your children. I ask, Father God, that you would be so kind, that you would send your Holy Spirit to use me for your purpose. Let me hide behind your divine will, dear God, that you would cover me. And dear God, let the Holy Spirit come down and shower down his wisdom. Let Father God, that I have nothing. And you will be always. In Jesus' precious name we pray. God's divine confirmation. I come to tell Mount Zion that you have been chosen as a people and a place as God's instrument. Pastor came one day and informed us that Mount Zion has been chosen to be a place where God's prayer is heard. And now we have a corporal prayer, which is 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. But I want you to know that God has given me the opportunity to let you know that as an instrument for his prayer, Mount Zion, you have been chosen. And as his chosen particular people, God will use you for his purpose. And I want you to know, ladies and gentlemen, Mount Zion, because it has been chosen by God to be his place, the sacrifice of prayer, because of your participation, our prayers have been heard by God, and he is here to give you his promises. And that is a word that God came and laid on my heart, that our prayers have been heard, our prayers have been attentive, and I have seven statements that the Lord laid on my heart to bring to Mount Zion's attention. His first praise is in the word of God is that he And he say, if the second thought that we have here, which is a part of the first thought, is that he considered you his, which I consider to be a privilege. When God takes note of who you are and what you're doing by calling you his own, that means you and me, we belong to God. That means that as a recipient of the promise that he's making to you, you are his people, and he's calling you that you belong to him. How many of us know that there's something that belongs to you? When you go to the refrigerator, that particular soda belongs to you. You got your claim on it. That's mine. And that's what God is saying about you and I. He's claiming you and I as his own. That right there should let you know that you're privileged. And when you know that you're privileged, you should look towards knowing that whenever something you say or whenever you take it to God, you can look forward to him. That's a privilege. When it's a privilege to know that God has claimed you as his own, that ought to make you stand just a little bit tall, make you put towards anything that God has asked you to do to put a little emphasis toward it. And that's the first one. And he said that when we belong to him, this is a privilege, that because you are God's own. Now, I know some of us know that we all belong to God, and that's good. He said all of God's children. That's good. But it's even better, and it has emphasis on it, when he claimed you as his own. And that means a lot when God lets you know that you belong to him. See, everybody is called, but very few are chosen. And when he has chosen you, Mount Zion, he has given you the privilege of being what is his, which means that when it's time for you to go down in prayer, you look towards the fact that you know that you're talking to somebody personally, and you have been given the privilege of knowing that you have been given a personal invitation. Praise God. My second claim is that because he has claimed you as his own, we come to him in complete humility. Humility. Humility is to take that self-look at yourself and humble yourself, because even though God has called you, you and I both have not been
few things I said, and there's a few things I saw, and I have to ask God to forgive me, because in my imperfected body, as much as I want to do right, I have to trust in the power of God to lead me back to his knee, to be back to the altar, to talk to him, and let him know, Lord, I messed up. There's some things I said, there's some things I thought, there's some things I even wanted to give into, but Lord, thank you for the power of Holy Ghost.
Seek his favor. We come that God will hear
into wicked ways. It's the only concern about the wicked ways, my wicked way. And I know that in order for you to have God to do the fall in the order of the will of God, you know, some things that you got to give up. I don't know, but I ain't stepping on no toes. But if anybody, I can just talk about myself. I can talk about me because I'm the only one that can smack me around besides God and the nonsense that I do. So I know that you got to turn from your wicked ways. And in order for you to take the turn from your wicked ways, you have to take a self-reflective look at yourself. You know what you're lacking.
Amen.
You know what you're not doing.
Yes.
You know what you ain't putting up when you're supposed to. Mm-hmm. You know that all the time you ain't giving your tithes the way you're supposed to. You know every now and then you're a little stingy and don't give God what belongs to him. Every now and then you don't do what God asks you to do. Every now and then you can be nice, but you can be ugly at the same time. I ain't talking about nobody with me. But praise God, everybody in here doing exactly what we're supposed to do. So that means when you take a self-respective look at yourself, when you look at yourself in the mirror, you know what you lack. You know what you're not doing. I ain't talking about nobody, but look at yourself in the mirror. You have to look at yourself in the mirror. And you got to be honest enough with yourself. How they say, they got a cliche that say, be real. Be for real. That's what you got to do. You got to be honest with yourself. You got to look at yourself in the mirror and see what it is that you're not living up to. That's being real. That's taking it to another level. That's taking us to step number 5. Because with all the things that I'm making notice of, these are some of the things that help you. And it's just little baby steps. They're just little baby steps. Don't take much. All you have to just do is be honest. It ain't nothing wrong with it. If you know that God not liking it, bring it to him. He'll help you out. If you ain't got no control, he got control. And can't nobody change you but Jesus. People get out here and try to change and rearrange it and make a mess of it. Only person can change you but Jesus. Because I know where I was a wretch undone. I was on my way to a burning hell. And Jesus stepped into my life and turned me around. But you know, I do realize he ain't done. It ain't done. I ain't reached it yet. I haven't reached perfection. When I reach perfection, that's when y'all are going to visit me at the place right there. Because then I will reach perfection. And Jesus will call me to the place where I have a home on the other shore. Just like the word of God said. Bye bye. Praise God. But that time ain't come yet. So in the meantime, while I'm here on earth, I got a lot of work to do. I ain't going to say a little bit of work. I got a lot of work to do. And the reason why I'm only talking about myself, because I don't want you rolling your eyes at me later on because I'm talking about you. something to break it up. Praise God, hallelujah. And he promised that he will know and see that God will perpetuate his glory in you. Perpetuate. Praise God, hallelujah. That means when you're praying for somebody, whether you like them or not, your prayers will come through. Praise God. Every now and then when you start talking to God the way you want to, you go home and find things in the way that you wanted to go. Every now and then people that you're talking about in prayer, you find out that things are going all right when you're and that he would touch your soul and bless it. It's a privilege. I just want y'all to know. It's a privilege when I go to God in prayer. It's a privilege. I love Jesus. He saved my life. He turned me around. I was a wretch undone. But God changed things around. And the same way he can mess with a wretch like me, I know he can do what's able to you. So will there be one? Will there be one? Praise God. Opportunity to come to you in prayer. Bless us continuously as we are your mission.